what advantage we have on the hydroponic farming and the traditional farming. So traditional farming, the location is very much limited to the farm operations. We have to do the traditional farming where the farms are located, where we have a good quality of a soil, where we have a good quality of humus into it. Even if you are using proper kind of a fertilizer or something, what is the fertilizer ratio already present into the land? We have to consider all these things when doing the traditional farming. In hydroponic farming, we had no connection with the land. So we can, every time it's a rinse and repeat system, every time it is a fresh system. So we can do it on a farmland, we can do it on a terrace, we can do it in the closed environment, we can do it into the containers, we can do it wherever we want, however we want. We had a total control over the growing conditions of the crop. We didn't have those, leverages when we go to the traditional farming. So traditional farming was very much limited to the farmlands, and the hydroponic farm was, it can be expanded into wherever we want, however we want, and whatever conditions we want. So that was the biggest advantage we had into hydroponic farming. So when we talk about the climate dependency, in hydroponic farm, you have understood by now, we had a zero climatic dependency. Even it's raining outside, even if it's misting outside, even it's winter outside, or it's summer outside. Inside the poly house, we had nothing to worry about. We had a constant supply, we had a constant quality. On traditional farming, we are faced a lot of small issues like, okay, if there is a fog outside, so the plants are turning yellow. If there is not ample of sunlight, the sunlight is not enough, the plants started slowly dying off. The photosynthesis was very slow. We face a lot of challenges like this. Even if you are using pesticides, if you cannot control that, okay, this is the only row which is pest infested, and we want to use pesticides only on this row. We didn't have that much of a control on the traditional farming. It was spreading to the next regions, in the different regions of the farm. We didn't have that kind of a control. So climatically, it was not a proven system. Climatically, it was not controlled, or climatically, we cannot say it was like foolproof, secure system. So traditional farming, we had that kind of issues. In hydroponic farm, we never had those kind of issues. Now let's talk about the quality. Whenever we want to sell this produce to the market, and then where the unit economics is, we did all the production and everything, you want to send our harvest to the market, and market will pay money against them. So whenever we are sending our produce to the market, every time in traditional farming, you have to find different kind of vendors. We cannot sell base yield to the same vendor constantly, because we don't have a constant production. We have a seasonal production. So for example, in winter, if I'm doing the basil production, I'm finding a new vendor for the basil. In rainy season, if I'm doing chili, so I have to find a new vendor for chili. If I'm doing the summer, if I'm doing capsicum or I'm doing the lettuce, I have to find a new vendor for that. So in hydroponic, what happens is I have a single vendor who needs all year around the basil. I can supply the basil to him. Every time I don't have to find a new vendor, I have a constant quality and I have a constant control over the quality for an entire year. So finding a single vendor, providing him with a constant quality production was like easily possible into the hydroponic farm, which was not possible into traditional farming. Let's talk about the pest control. So when we built a poly house, so we got a little bit control over the pests. So pest infestation was very less. Soil-borne disease were zero. So that gives us a lot of advantage into hydroponic farming, that we had to use zero pest control mechanism for the hydroponic farming. Yes, we did little bit of a pest control mechanisms, but they were very much traditional. Like we had a trappers, then we had a blue stick bars. We had different kind of pest control mechanisms, but it was not directly connected with the plants anyway. We didn't use single kind of a chemicals. We didn't use single kind of a pesticides on direct plant productions. In traditional farming, we were highly dependent on the pest control. We are dependent on the different kind of a pest control, which are like, it clearly when we are using the pest control for the traditional farming, every time we had a guilt feeling whenever we read poison onto it. Every time we are pushing poisons in the traditional farming just to control the pest. And this poison is going nowhere. It's in the end, it's going into the plant, and ultimately it's going in the human consumption. So we had to use a lot of pesticides to control our production into traditional farming. In hydroponic farm, we never had that guilt feeling. We are like, we're 100% sure whatever we are producing, it's 100% nutritious, and there is not a single trace of a poison into it. So we are so much sure about that. So there was a zero pest control. We are saving a lot of money on pest control as well. We are not spending any money on pesticides. We are not spending any man hours or labor hours on the spraying of pesticides. We are not spending any money on the equipments which we need for the pesticide spraying. We are saving a lot of money on that part as well. So let's talk about the pricing.